I literally, my first day of work ever as a teacher was the Friday that they canceled school. Like, they switched to online. So I was there for one day, and then it was like, okay, we're switching to online. And that was my first day of teaching ever. So that was insane. I'm a first year teacher at St. Francis Junior High School in Lethbridge, Alberta, and I am actually in charge of the multi-age program. So that means I have grade 7s, 8s, and 9s in my room at all times. And the program is designed basically for students with maybe learning disabilities or exceptional needs. So I work with about 20 students. I have them, all day long because of COVID. Normally, we'd have them out in the, you know, the rest of the school doing options or religion class or other things, but because of COVID and cohorts, they're with me all day long. It was almost kind of refreshing that everyone was starting at the same spot as me. Like, coming into this hard position, no one else had experience teaching online before, right? So in a sense, everyone was kind of like first year teachers for that first, you know, few months there, because we all had no idea what we were doing. So it was almost like, yeah, that first day was like horrifying. But then after that, I realized, hey, we're all in this together and we're all kind of struggling with the same things. Whereas I think in a normal year, a first year teacher is almost a little more alone in those struggles because all the other teachers have been there. They kind of know your routines and how it works. So I guess if you're looking for positives, that's definitely one of them.
So I honestly think I see myself as pretty lucky that it was my first year of teaching and during this pandemic, because I didn't have a lot of set practices of how I do things. And so for me, I was just creating things and teaching to accommodate like the pandemic. I didn't have to change things to accommodate the pandemic. And so I felt like that was a lot easier than having a lot of set practices that needed to move around. Like, I've just, for me, it'll be a nice surprise and it'll be interesting to see if it feels easier when the pandemic's gone, because this is what I'm used to now. I don't know what it was like to really teach before the pandemic.
And then I guess with COVID, obviously it kind of changes your teaching style. You can't do as many hands-on things. You can't do the fun group activities, right? I find in myself, I'm like brainstorming, oh, what should we do, you know, for math this week? Oh, I have an idea. And then quickly followed by, oh, wait, can't do it because of COVID. Like, that's been a pattern this whole year. And so that's a little frustrating to deal with. But I mean, it's a reality, and the fact is that safety is priority, so.
I definitely think that it affects the kids' mental health a lot more than one would think. Like, you would think that they're kids and they're relentless and they can get through anything, but I have noticed that that's not the case. Like, kids are feeling this too, not being able to see their friends outside of school or their cousins, or not being able to hug them or even like sit really next to them. Like, that really is harder. Even for me, I'm like, if I see a kid that's sad, I want to give them a hug. And like, I'm not supposed to. And it's hard. And I think the kids really miss that connection. And if they don't always get that kind of love elsewhere, like, I want to be able to give it to them at school. And so I think it's just hard that they're not able to see all of their friends or family or cousins or whatnot whenever they want to see them. Like, they're having to just stay within their households. And I think that that's really hard for them as well. But I do know that they are utilizing like technology and gaming and all of that to stay in touch. And so I'm glad that they're able to at least have that outlet to express themselves and to connect with their loved ones.
And then I guess the only other thing that's really been a struggle this year as a first year teacher in COVID is just not being able to form, you know, like the staff relationships that all the other teachers have, or the parent relationships that are crucial as well. You know, staff welcome parties, or there's no lunchtime in the staff room because you can't. So that's been tough, but I know that when this is over, then we can make those relationships.
I actually did all of my practicums in the Holy Spirit School Division. Being in a Catholic school, like, faith is everywhere. And so I get to now spend my whole day surrounded by the Catholic faith and by people who share the same beliefs as me. And so that has really helped me to grow in it and also to learn in it. When I go to teach it, I'm like, oh, this is stuff that I haven't, you know, thought about since I was in elementary school, and I was being taught this. And so it helps me to also understand my faith better and, you know, different parts of it that maybe I forgot about over the years. Being able to teach the kids and build those relationships with them and watch how they strengthen their relationship with God and flourish that way, like, that kind of you know, sealed the deal for me, knowing that I could have a effect on students' lives and I could help them to build those relationships with God.
In my opinion, being a Catholic teacher is almost more freeing in a sense. And I know that sounds a little backwards because you're thinking, well, there's all, you know, all these rules and regulations with, you know, Catholicism and the teachings and whatnot. But it's freeing because I get to be who I am and I don't have to hide that for fear of, you know, government regulations or anything like that. I can be who I want and I can talk how I am and I can teach my kids to be who they want, right? And there's none of that, there's no restrictions on that. And so that's really freeing to me. And that's something I think I take for granted. I've never worked in a public school, but just knowing that I wouldn't be able to incorporate that style into my teaching, yeah, that's a huge, huge difference, I think. I think that would really change because, you know, your faith makes you who you are. Knowing that God has a plan and He isn't just gonna abandon us ever, that has really been something I've been holding on to, especially in these last, you know, year and a half or so, when things are so uncertain, things are so scary, knowing and trusting that someone's looking out for you and it'll be okay, and to trust in Him, I think that's really helped form my teaching, because that confidence and that peace helps translate into my classroom.